He has a question which I would like all of you, some of you, to answer. If you have a person who has schizophrenia, have you heard the word schizophrenia? Yeah, it's a very commonly heard term, not a very common disorder, but a very severe mental illness. Then who will you refer him to? Yes. Why is that so? Right. A schizophrenia is severe, it's a psychotic disorder on the last, where I put 100%. So there is a total breakdown of reality. The person is not able to function, or like his day-to-day jobs, he cannot do things he can't do.
So,
there is. Yes.
Will you put dementing on that? Put dementing on that? Dementing.
Dementia.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yes. Dementia is more age-related psychological deterioration. But a psychiatrist can help you. Whenever you feel there might be some kind of a chemical imbalance related to this, or if the extent of the mental problem is very severe, firstly a psychiatrist has to come in the picture, because he'll make an assessment of what is the disorder the person is facing. Just as in biological you have so many types of issues, that's why also mind also there's a whole classification. If you are interested, you can read DSM-4. You know, that's like a whole clinical manual of all the disorders, and the degree and severity, everything is listed and it's tabulated out there. How do you decide if you need help? How will you think or decide whether or not you need help? When you can't cope with the daily life. Okay. Anything else? Yes. When you're feeling extreme degree of loneliness. See, everything, when we're talking normal, abnormal, the duration is very important, the severity is very important of what you're feeling. If you're feeling something for a very long time, if you're feeling something very severely, both these things factors will decide whether or not you need help. If you've been feeling very sad for a very long period of time, and it's very intense sadness to the extent that you can't carry on your day-to-day life work. You don't feel like going to work, you don't feel like meeting anybody, you lose interest in all the things that you enjoy, you don't want to talk to anybody, then it shows, then you have to keep all your mental, that bulb has to be on within you, that I think there's something not right here. Because everybody around me is going on with their lives, they're doing their normal life, and you know, it's not that they are not facing any problems, it's not that life is better for them. Everybody has, whether you're rich or whether you're poor, and whether you're single, whether you're married, whether you have children, or no matter whatever age and stage in life you are at, you will have some issues to deal with. So don't ever think that the grass is greener on the other side and somebody else is having a better life than you are. It just means they're coping better with their lives. If you see happy people around you, it means that they are dealing better with their lives. It's not because of they have more money and they have a better family and things like that. So if you are not able to deal with your life and what's on your plate, please make a whole, sit down with a paper and pen. Think about your life. What are your challenges? What are your responsibilities? How are you handling them? And if you think you're not doing a good job, if you think that you're losing your motivation, you're very disinterested, all the time you're low, sad, negative, if the quality of your relationships is another factor for to look out. If you find that you're full of negativity or you're shunning people all the time, you don't have satisfactory relationships, whether it's family, relatives, friendships, that's also another big sign that, you know, you're psychologically you're not well. So how will, you said, we were talking about how will you decide if you need help? I can hear words, but I can't hear what you're saying.
Psychosomatic disease, why affect the body? As a psychotic change,
Right. Very often what happens is the first door that you knock whenever you have a problem, and because of this whole taboo that we have about mental health, the first door you knock is your GP, the doctor that you go to see for your routine ailments. You will go to him and say, oh, this is happening, that is happening, this is happening, that is happening. So he has to be smart enough to pick out that I think you need to go and see a counselor. So I think a lot of GPs need to be trained. I know that earlier they were being trained. I'm not sure how they are doing about referring. If you go to them and they think that some of your symptoms that you are experiencing are psychosomatic, they have to send you to a counselor or a psychiatrist. If you are having recurrent symptoms, or sometimes you will find, okay, you are tackling one symptom but the other symptom is appearing. Then other symptom you are handling, then something else is happening. So constantly, you know, it's like a cyclical disturbance in your body. That also would, you have to, unless there is an organic cause, there is a psychological component to it.
In the wivering mind?
Wivering mind is just a personality trait. It's not any related to any severe mental health disorder. Wavering mind. We are talking about how will you decide if you need help.
What I perceive is that excessiveness in some situation, a person, I think you are kind of any kind of environment, that can result in something to more reality is there.
Obsessing that, about something.
Obsessive, any kind of thing, excessive thought.
I think let's not get into this disorder is this or this or this. Very often mental health professionals work together to help people who have particular problems. So a psychotherapist and a psychiatrist, or a counselor and a psychiatrist, will team up. One will deal with medication, because psychiatrists will not get into counseling. They will not sit with you and say, oh, what happened? How are you feeling about this? Typically, a counselor or a psychotherapist will say, so this happened. So how does that make you feel? That will be the first thing, and or mostly a repetitive thing, that because they want to understand what are you feeling all the time. Because your feelings are a very key thing, a tool for a counselor or a psychotherapist to use. A psychiatrist will just ask you, what are your symptoms? This is the medication. Is it helping you? Not. Let's reduce it. Let's try other medication. If there is a chemical imbalance or there is some organic problem, then just counseling will not help. Sadness and loneliness, see, it's not, all of us are familiar with sadness and loneliness. It's not that we have never felt it. Yeah? Everybody has felt sad and lonely sometimes in your life. If whatever you're feeling is, as I said, the duration and the severity, keep that in mind. If it's very severe feeling, it's making you a dysfunctional person, where you can't get out of your home and you can't make contact with people, you can't go to your work or do anything which makes you a productive person in society. That is the time when you need help. That is showing the severity of it. And duration means if more than 15 days, if something, you know, the feeling continues, that definitely shows your inability to handle it. Counseling is always the first step. But very often a counselor may refer you to added professionals. Sometimes they may work together, sometimes only one professional is needed. Counselor will always definitely will make an initial, whoever you go to from all these, will make an initial assessment of what you're feeling, what you're facing. They'll take all your background history and everything. And if they think that it is not a problem which is related to what they are dealing with, they'll refer you to the person who is the right person.
Okay, any problem does not be affected the whole problem.
Sorry?
Right.
Right. When we are talking about mind, a lot of patients, clients, or people in general, what they are looking for is somebody to understand what they are feeling. Because the main thing about mental illness is it gives you a sense of isolation. It makes you feel very different. You feel you are the only one carrying that problem within yourself, or you are the only one facing life. Life seems very different to you. Everybody else seems together. You feel like you've fallen out of it. So you need a person who's trained and who can understand you at from where you are without judging you. Very often the reason why we don't open up and...
In that case, a real friend is going to pull you through instead of psychiatrist. Sometimes we will be with two, three friends. And if you share your problems to him, the problem may be solved by a friend or so.
Right. I think I'm glad you are talking about this because I really want to bust this misconception number. It's a big, huge misconception that your friends and family, of course your friends and family are always there for you. They're very well-meaning, very well-concerned. And they will help you. But I'm saying that does not, you cannot underestimate the importance of a trained person who has trained and spent several years of training and understanding mind, behavior, and emotions. Because it's a very complex thing. When we are talking about human mind, it's a very complex phenomena. So if you need normal support and all that, your friends and family are there for you. But what a psychologist or a counseling, anybody here who has been to a counselor, if you don't mind putting up your hand and saying, you don't have to share your experience, just say that I have been to a counselor. You have been to a counselor. Okay. I'm saying is you have to be in a counselor session to know what a counselor does. Very often, I'm saying in my early part of training, for me it used to be really bugging to explain to people that, listen, I'm not a teacher. You know, people used to come and tell me, will you give tuitions to my child? Will you do this? Will you teach that? I'm not that, you know. I had to tell them because they couldn't just get it, you know. And after 15 years, I'm still talking about understanding mental health. So you can imagine. That's right. I'm saying, see, if you see in the US, people, if you see even Western movies, Hollywood movies, everybody talks about having a shrink. Because there, it's on the other extreme. It's fashionable to have a counselor or a personal. It's like you go to your hairdresser, you go to your doctor, you have your own shrink. Somebody, wherever you